Hi, I'm Erin from Broke Millennial for The Financial Diet. Welcome to the 3-Minute Guide brought to you by Skillshare. Emergency funds. It's the money that you set aside for when something goes wrong and your regular budget just can't cover the cost. It's the tied-to-go stick in your purse, that bat that's next to your bed. It's not something that you want to use, but it's good that it's there just in case. Things are going to go wrong. That is a guarantee. But you don't want to be forced to decide which bills you can pay because you can't afford them all. Having this spare stash of cash mitigates that risk. Yes, you should have one, even if you're paying down debt. Paying off debt without an emergency fund in place really just sets yourself up to incur more debt. It can take years, even decades, to pay down your debt, and I promise something is going to go wrong during that time. Zeroing cash reserves means you're likely to have to finance that misfortune on a credit card, which means you're just going to restart the debt payoff cycle that never feels like it ends. Not all personal finance experts agree on this point. Some believe that you shouldn't bother having an emergency fund when you're paying down debt and just put all your extra cash towards being debt-free. But there's one important thing you have to know about yourself first. What is your relationship to debt and risk? This comes back to the debt snowball versus debt avalanche methods of paying off debt. There's a link to that video in the description. The snowballers need that psychological win up top in order to push through and keep going to pay off debt. The avalanchers are motivated by the numbers and getting debt-free faster and paying the least amount of interest. For some people, incurring more debt is just going to be demoralizing and risk completely throwing them off their repayment journey. For others, it's the punch in the teeth they need to get even more aggressive. So how much should you have? That's the big question. The rule of thumb typically swings somewhere between 3 months worth of living expenses and 9 months worth of living expenses. Some people even advise you just have $1,000 if you're paying off debt. Sadly, $1,000 really doesn't cover all that much in the case of many emergencies. Before you panic that it is impossible to save a couple months worth of living expenses, first consider what your actual bare minimum living expenses are. Non-essentials get cut in an emergency. So don't be thinking about the amount that you need for the lifestyle that you're currently accustomed to when everything is going swimmingly. Instead, what do you need to cover your bills, get to your job, or be out job hunting, and put food on the table? That's your bare minimum cost of living and should be your first goal. And your emergency fund needs to be liquid. The point of an emergency fund is to have easy and immediate or near immediate access to your money. Having to liquidate investments will take time and could mean you risk losing money if you have to take it out during a market correction. Curious about where to store your emergency fund? You for sure want a big chunk of your emergency fund in a plain vanilla savings account, preferably one earning you at least 1% APY. Trying to pad that emergency fund can be an overwhelming part of this equation, which is why side hustles and passive income can be so helpful. An easy and affordable way to expand your talents and potentially your side hustles is with Skillshare. Every week, we're featuring a different Skillshare class we think you guys will love. This week's class is Start a Creative Passive Income Business for Free in 7 days or Less. Hosted by the artist Julie Tillman, this class teaches you an easy way to start creating an online business that generates passive income for you. As always, though, Skillshare offers a huge range of classes on everything from writing to fitness to business, and it's all about what you want to learn at an affordable annual subscription of less than $10 a month. And since Skillshare is sponsoring this video, the first 500 people to use the promo link in the description will get their first 2 months for 99 cents. Click the link in the description and check out this week's featured class or any of the other classes Skillshare has to offer. Have a money question you want to learn more about? Leave your topic idea in the comments section below. I'm Erin from Broke Millennial for The Financial Diet, and don't forget to be here next Thursday for a new 3-Minute Guide.